Hey. Okie doke. So sitting tall. Double check if I'm connected to my AirPods. Sitting nice and tall on your chair, close to the edge, so you're not slumping. And I'm breathing through your nose if possible, sitting tall. Feeling the feet on the floor and the sit bones on the chair. See if you can just elongate your breath a little bit more than you normally breathe. Nice long in breath. Feel the belly and the ribs expand. And nice long exhale. Add one more breath, and then we can reach the arms up and overhead, and then out to the side. Arms out to the side, palms facing forward, and then looking to the right, and then inhale, look up, maybe a slight chin looks up, and then exhale, look to the left, arms to the side. Inhale, look up slightly. Hello. And then going like that. Looking up and looking to the side. And looking up and look to the side. And then look up one more time. And then we'll go forward, hinging forward, coming all the way down towards your thighs. And then halfway up into that seated cobra. So elbows in, shoulders down, and squeeze the shoulder blades back. Try to broaden those collarbones. So squeeze those shoulders back. Good. And then exhale fully down. And inhale all the way up. Big stretch. Lift your heart up and hands to your heart. Good. And then one more inhale up. And then exhale, forward fold into the hips. Go down. Inhale halfway up into that seated cobra. Fold the shoulders and down and back. And exhale down. And inhale all the way up and hands to your heart. We're gonna try to do the opposite elbow to knee. So you're twisting, not really flexing forward. You're just trying to keep the spine nice and tall, but you're moving across the midline. So elbow to opposite knee. Good. Very good. And then I'll go sideways, down on one side, And then reach the other arm up. Keep that core engaged to hold against gravity. And then back, stir. Down on the other side and then extend that arm so you're being pulled apart. And back to center. Let's do it one time on each side. Down and reach up. And back in. And down and reach up. And back in. Great. And then let's just straighten the leg one at a time to warm up. Try to lift that leg nice and high up too. Morning, everyone. Good. And now let's do the ankle circles. And reverse. Another side. And reverse. Perfect. All right, let's do some stand-ups and sit-downs, some music. So you guys go up and down from your chairs. All right. Come on, music. Sorry. For some reason, I can't hear the music. Oh, yeah. Oh, sorry, I need to try to connect again. Somehow it disconnected me. So you guys can stand up and do some heel lifts, maybe standing behind your chair while I try to fix this. So lifting up and down on your toes. Why? We'll do. Oh, there we go. Finally. Okay. There. Marching. And then let's keep the elbows in, and then just bring the forearm out and back. Forward, and then possibly as far back as possible. Squeeze those shoulders back. Keep it there for a while. Feel that squeeze. And then back. Yeah. And then we'll go up and down while you march. Cross above your head. And then we'll go forward cross and then squeeze back. Good. All right. Do some wrist circles. So just at this joint, right? The wrist. And then top the knees. And then let's move the hips side to side. To the side. Good. And then a whole circle. We'll just reach to the side so your pelvis and legs are still. Now you're just reaching. So keep your feet flat on the floor. So you're not lifting the heel. Both feet flat. So you feel it more here as you reach. Just to the side. Good. Nice. Good. And then up. And then bend the knees, go forward, right? And down. And up. And forward. And down. And up. Forward. And down. Up. Forward. Bend those knees. And down. Up. Forward. Down. Up, forward, and down. And last one, up, forward, and down. Okay. And then let's do like a tap. You shift the weight and you're tapping with a toe. Tap, tap, tap. You're keeping the legs wide, right? It's not a tap touch. Tapping, not close to your ankle, but out to the side. It's a little different than what we normally do. Good. And then we'll go for full set. And then back together. And then again, same side. And a few more. Same side and back. Out and back. Use that strength of your legs. Back. So now you're shifting weight into that leg and then pushing back. Okay, one last one on the side and then we'll switch. So now we're going with your right leg. Same thing. Switch weight into this and then push back. Out and together. that knee as you push that or transfer the weight into that leg. Good. Last one. Good. And back to march. Okay. Now we're gonna try to do. We're gonna go one wing up, other wing up, and then one knee up and other knee up. Okay. So let's do one, two, three, and four. And back up. And then one, two, and three, and four. And then lift one wing, other wing, one knee, and other knee. Good. And then let's do both. Lift the elbows up and down. Good. Nice. Yeah, try not to lift your shoulders up. It's just these muscles here, right? Okay. And then let's do cross the arms in front of you, lift, and then split. And for someone else, but not nice big circle. Big movement. Reach up high. That's the way it seems. Disappointment haunted. And I saw her face. Now I'm a believer. Got to lean forward, lean down a little bit. Good. And let's do the switch. Pivot on the foot. Take the hips with you. I couldn't leave her if I tried. I thought love was more or less. Try when you come in the center, try to do that power up, right? Then come back to power up and then twist. Open, lift. Open, twist. Open, twist. Open, twist. When I needed sunshine, I got rain. Oh, then I saw her face. Now I'm a believer. Not a trace. Good. Nice. And then my big arm swing. Good. And then we'll go this way, both arms. Then I saw her face. And then circle. I'm a believer. Not a train. Hooked out in my mind. I'm in love. Reverse. I'm a believer. I couldn't leave her if I tried. Yes, I saw her face. Now I'm a believer. Yeah. Let's go up and touch the back of the head out to the side for Y and touch the back of the neck. Breathing. Good. And shoulder circle. The heel back towards your butt. And then if you're afraid, you can try to turn with it. So just keep turning while you're kicking your butt. I can go the other way. Keeping those legs nice and wide. You turn. Watch out for any obstacles. Nice. And then we'll do the rocking and reaching. You can maybe even try to lift that foot off the floor. Big reach. Dip and reach. At least lifting the heel, alright? Good. And then back to arch. Let's, before we do the, our jumba, let's do circles with the thumbs. It only makes it worse to live. Thumbs, just the thumb. And just the index finger. And just the middle finger. Just the ring finger. And then just the pinky. Good. And then shake it out. Good. All right, let's get our dumbbells ready.
One, two, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, rock. Five, six, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, rock. Nine, 10, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, rock. We're gonna rock around the clock tonight. Put your glad rags on. Join me home. We'll have some fun when the clock strikes one. We're gonna rock around the
clock. Okay, I'm just gonna explain. If you were in the in-person class on Friday, we're gonna do the same exercises plus some others. We were doing this for the 45 seconds. We're doing just one leg. You're gonna be moving forward, side, and back, and doing the opposite arm with it. So right leg, left arm, forward, side, and then back, arm goes back, leg goes back. And then you go again, same limb, out, and back. Okay, right? So forward, side, when the chimes back. So you're pushing that arm back. And then we'll switch to the other side. Okay, and then one of them is where you go into the sideline, on the bend. And then you go elbows up. One, three, right? So notice my body is sort of hinging at the hips. The more you're closer to the floor with your chest, the harder you have to work by the gravity, right? So the row is more. Not like this. Not like this. Like this, right? You feel it in the back. Yeah, in the back. So it's not a tricep, but the back muscle. Alright. Do this. So first, one, two, three, and then push slightly ahead of you. Get ready, go. One, two, three, quad, and then push up. One, two, three, one, two, three, up. Two, three, up. One, two, three, up. One, two, three, up. Halfway. One, two, three, up. One, two, three, push up. One, two, three, up. Perfect. And rest. So now we're gonna do the lunge. So let's use your right leg forward, side. Back. Okay, so both arm and leg go back. Ready, set, go. Forward, opposite arm and leg. Side. And again, same leg. Forward, side, back. Forward,
side. Back. Forward. Side. Back. Forward. Side. Back. Forward. Side. Back. 10 seconds on the side. 1, 2, 3. All right. Then we'll do it for the other side after the break. So left leg forward, right arm move. Right side and back. Right. Ready? Back. Go. Left leg, right arm forward, side, back. Forward, side, and then back. Push that arm back. Forward, side. Forward, side. Back. Forward, side. Back. Forward, side. Back. Forward. Side, back, last one, forward, side, perfect. Now we do the side, side lunge, 1, 2, 3, and then you go to the other side, 1, 2, 3. So nice wide stance, right, so you can straighten one leg, 1, 2, 3, chest up. 1, 2, 3. Get those elbows back. Right behind your back. 9, that's it. 3. 1, 2, 3. Shift away. 1, 2, 3. And shift. 1, 2, elbows back, elbows back. All right, last one, 1, 2, 3. Good. Okay, so now, again, across the midline, you're gonna punch up, side, down, across, and then other side. Punch across and up, across to the side, across and down, center, up. Side, down, and then other side, up, side, down, up, side, down, up, side, down, up, side, side, down, and across. Up across, side across, down across. Good. And then rest. Just turn around now. You're not welcome anymore. Okay, so now we're gonna do a split stance. As you rock, you're gonna rock forward, do a bicep curl, and then tricep extension as you go back. So rocking, lifting the toes, lifting the heel, and then bending at the elbow. Right for bicep curl, and then straighten those elbows, push those arms back. Keep lifting those toes and lifting the heel. Try not to use momentum like, you know, this, right? But it's good. And then we'll switch sides, other leg forward. And so we'll just go like this. Okay, so you're still rocking, but doing that bicep curl, but out of the side. Let's see if you can still rock. Thank you.
done. Almost done. Keep rocking. Excellent. And that release. Okay, so next one. You can do either this, so side to side, or lift the knee. Okay, so if that's too much, you can do side to side, like that, or add that knee lift. You're turning towards that knee. Both dumbbells towards your hip. You can bring them a little bit down towards the hip. Very good. Almost there. Last one, good. And rest. Okay. So now we're gonna do the butt kickers. And then you're gonna add this movement. Actually, let's lock the elbow so you're doing supination pronation. So moving the end out and in, right? Out, in, out, in. And then possibly adding that rock and lift of the heel. Lift, turn. That's it. Perfect, and release. Okay, the next one is a sort of like a standing bird dog where you're lifting the opposite leg. You can do it with the dumbbells or without. If lifting all the way is too much, you could just tap behind you, right? Like that. Or tap. Keep breathing. Straight leg, straight leg back. Excellent, and rest. So next time will be step and punch, step, punch, big step, sideways, big step, punch. And you can try to keep up the knees a little bit, like you're a little bit low, right? Punch. Like bending the knees. So the quads have a little bit more work. So you're staying a little bit low. Take those big steps. Perfect, and rest. All right, now we're gonna just jog. Okay, you can big feet or march. Ready, set, go. Quick feet for 45 seconds. Good job, everyone. Halfway. 10 seconds. Lisa. Okay, so the next one is a deadlift. So you're just a tiny bend, not too much, not a squat. But you're getting down, rolling down your legs until your back is at least almost parallel to the floor or even lower. And then you squeeze the buttocks and then roll back up. And then down, roll down, squeeze the buttocks and get yourself up. Now rounding in the back. You're not rolling up in the back, right? The back stays straight. Not vertebrae by vertebrae rolling. The back, kind of like you swallowed a rod. So the force sort of comes out of your butt and hamstring. To get yourself straight up. Good. All right, and rest. Okay, two more. So we're gonna draw an X. You're gonna go up, down and across, down and across, down and across. Keep the core engaged. Cross it up, almost there. Down and up. Perfect. All right, and the last one is just rolling down to the side bend. So going side to side, reaching down, using the weight to get you a little bit deeper. Into the stretch. So keep your knees straight, feet flat. You're just bending in the side. Keep your chest and shoulders in one line, so you're not dropping the shoulder forward, right? You're staying in a nice side bend. Good. Perfect. Done. Now I'm warm. Got my woolen shirt. Grab some water. Stretch it. Okay. You could hold on to the chair, just big bend the front knee, possibly your heel is up, but you could also bring it down and then you can try lift up. Back leg straight, front knee bend. Bring those elbows, lift the heart. Good, and then switch sides. Side relax forward. Knee bend. Front knee bend. Back leg straight. Lift those arms up, lift the heart. Breathe. Good, and then now let's do downward dog. So either with the
posture with the lower part of the chair, or more hands up here in the higher part, or we can do it facing down on the floor.
Magic mirror on the wall, who's the fairest, she called them all.
Swing, so elongate your back. Okay, so elongate your spine. Try to lift your tailbone just a bit.
Good, and then
we're all gonna go down onto our knees. Your knees. And then we'll work on stepping forward with the foot. So option is to be on all fours, and then, you know, stepping forward, just alternating sides. If that's too much, it's not possible for you, you can have the hands up here and then a little bit higher. All right, so otherwise, all fours, and then you step forward and then come back, and step forward and come back. Yeah, so keep going, keep alternating, step forward, and step forward, get those hips. If you want to stand, just keep stepping, but take a big step, right? So step on that knee and push back, step. Good. And then we're gonna try to take a twist. So either, let's say you step forward to your left leg, you could come up and then reach that left arm back, your chest twists to the left. So the right hand can be on your left knee. Then you're twisting. So it might be a little wobbly, so you have to engage the whole body. Good. And then back center. And then we'll switch sides. The other knee forward. The left hand on the right knee. And then twisting your body to the right, reaching the right arm back. Breathing. So you look to the side too. That might help you with the range of motion. You can even try to look back at the arm, if that's okay for your balance. A little wobbly. Good. All right. And then do the bit of a power up in the kneeling position. If you're okay at being on your knees, you're going to sort of like you're falling. So placing the hands down, bending the elbows, kind of like you want to kiss the floor, and then push yourself up into power up. Or if you don't want to go all the way to the floor, do it with the chair. Bend those elbows. Good. So down, kiss the floor. Power up. Good. All the way. Yeah, so your hips get forward and you feel that stretch in the whole front of the body. Good. Perfect. Okay. And then let's try one more thing here. So we're gonna sit, and then if it's possible for you, so your hands will be behind you, you can decide the position of the fingers. So they could either point towards your butt or away from your butt or to the side, whatever feels better on your wrist. And then we'll just try to lift the butt a few times and then exhale down. Lift and release. And lift and release. If you're seated,
You can do a few more stand-ups and squeeze the glutes as you stand up. Great. Okay. And you can sort of hug your knees in a little bit around your back. A little stretch between the shoulder blades. Okay. And so now, before you go down, I'm going to try to show you what we're going to do. So you're going to be on your back, and you're going to point the arms, the forearms up, right? So you're kind of like a goalpost, like this. And you're going to push those elbows into the floor. It's going to be an isometric hold. So you're not really moving, but you'll feel as you push those elbows in and the forearms into the floor, you'll feel the engagement in the back and the arms. You hold it for a few seconds and then release. You might even feel your chest sort of lifting a little bit as you push down, maybe like 60% of your force. Feel the sensation of around the shoulder blade and then release. All right, so you should feel it around in the back as you push down. So the forearms point up, yeah, towards the ceiling. You're pushing the elbows into the floor, forearms are pointing up towards the ceiling. Mary, yeah, keep the arms pointing up towards the ceiling. Yes, so keep the arms up and then just push the elbows into the floor. And then feel, don't lift your hips, don't lift your hips. You just push down. There's not much movement actually. You're just contracting the muscles in the back by pushing down into the floor, right? So you feel that strengthening in the back and in the arms. Good. All right, maybe one more time. And then we're going to do the stretch. I call it the opening of the book. So you're going to be on your side with your knees and hips and feet stacked, and your arms will be in front of you like this. And then you're going to keep the hips stacked, right? So you're not rolling over with the hips. So the pelvis is fixed. And then you're just opening through the upper back and reaching the arm back. Keep your knees together and then back to center. And then open, reach back. Your head is down. You're lying on your side. So your shoulders opening, keeping the knees together, feet together, hips open. Yeah, so it's for the mobility of the upper back. Good, and then if you've done it a few times, switch the hips. So roll over into your other hip and do the other side. Keep your knees down, right? Knees are to the side. So just your upper body is rolling open. Yeah, so Alex, you could do seated, you could do this. So reach that arm back, open the shoulders to the side. So it's a twist, right? It's a twist for your upper back. You might not reach all the way to the floor, and that's fine. Just keep your hips locked, so you're not working on the hips right now, but just the upper back. Just go as far as you can without pain. Yeah. Good. Yeah, Raju, you're rolling over your whole body. Keep your knees together. Squeeze the knees together. Keep them and keep the hips stacked. So you're only rotating in the back. All right, and then come back to center. And then hug your knees in into your chest, lying down on your back. You can rock side to side slightly. Good, and then let's just do one more exercise for the neck muscles. So you can try to keep the arms in cactus position, so bend at the elbows 90 degrees, and the arms are down on the floor. And then you're just gonna lift the head and look at your knees, and then hold it for a few seconds, and then relax slowly down. And then lift. And release. And if it's strained your neck, it is a exercise for the neck, so you're gonna feel it for sure. But hopefully no pain. So just lifting the head, look at the knees, and then relax the head again. Good, good, good. Perfect. All right, and then you can relax the arms, relax the head, maybe move the head side to side if there's any tension left. And then we'll do Shavasana. So find a comfortable position. And just really release all effort. And use this moment to scan your body, to connect to your body parts. Start with your feet, the toes. Your ankles. And your calves. And your knees. And your thighs, feel your thighs. Feel your pelvis. Feel your belly. Feel your back. And feel your shoulders. Feel your right arm. Right hand. And left arm. And left hand. And feel your neck. And feel your face. And then feel your whole body. And take a deep breath in. And then slowly start moving your fingers and toes. And maybe take a stretch. And when you're ready, you can roll over to your side, come up to sitting. Perfect. All right, so close the class with our little intention setting. Feel free to join. You could also send yourself any other words or qualities you need in your life. May I be happy. May I be healthy. May I be mindful. May I have courage. May I have fun. And may I treat myself and others with love and compassion. And then hands to your forehead as a reminder, the power of your word, of your thoughts. Hands to your lips as a reminder, the power of your words. And hands to your heart. As a reminder, the power of your actions. Great job, everyone. Give yourself a clap. All right. I hope your day goes great. Well, and I'll see you guys next week. Okay.
Thank you, Petra.
Thank you. Thank you.
Belated Happy Mother's Day to everyone who's a mom.
You too.
You too.
All right. Bye, everyone.